abortion for many, many years, since the 70s. She's a housing rights activist. She's somebody who's been on many front lines. She's somebody who founded the Street Harassment Project and has, for nearly 20 years, pioneered feminist radio in this city and has reached beyond this city. She's the executive director of Joy of Resistance Multicultural Feminist Radio on WBAI Pacifica Network. Join me in welcoming Fran Luck.
It's really an honor to be here and to be among those who want to take a stand and really fight back. Well, women's rights are going to take a huge hit in a Trump-Pence administration, and the work not only of decades but of literally generations of trying to bring women out of the slough of incredible oppression that was under rule of law in the past is going to be set way, way back. Unless we stop it. You've heard of the four horsemen of the apocalypse. Well, I'm going to call what women now face the three horsemen of the Trumpocalypse. They are, first of all, the groper-in-chief, Donald Trump himself, whose braggadocio about sexually assaulting women, because he could get away with it, has already led to numerous reported incidents of increased sexual harassment of women. Women are being grabbed by the crotch by men and by boys, in his name. One report I've read really stands out for its symbolism. A woman in Penn Station rejected a man's advances and was told, quote, "I can't wait until Trump gets elected so I can force bitches like you to their knees." The word bitch itself, which is so often used to dehumanize women and as a precursor to violence against women, has been totally normalized by the Trump campaign. There have been Nuremberg-like rallies where hordes of people yell, "Bitch, bitch, bitch," at his opponent Hillary Clinton and wore t-shirts saying the same thing. In Trump's America, the terrain for women is becoming very rough and very physically dangerous. And misogyny is, of course, intersectional, with women wearing hijabs or perceived as immigrants or women of color being doubly, triply in danger. Moving on, the second horseman of the Trumpocalypse is Mike Pence and the Christian evangelist that he represents. They want women to lose all autonomy in one of the most important decisions of her life, the right to decide when and if she bears children. Thousands of laws limiting this so far constitutional right to abortion have been passed in state after state, so that abortion is now not obtainable in 90% of U.S. counties, although it is still on the books. There are all kinds of limitations, from forced vaginal ultrasounds to parental notifications to having to travel to other states to get abortions and spend money that you may not have on hotel rooms and all of the costs associated with that kind of travel. That will, of course, increase under a Trump administration. Trump has, of course, said that he will appoint Supreme Court justices overturning Roe versus Wade, that women should be punished for having abortions, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Under Mike Pence in Indiana, we've had recently a law that, a law that would force women to have funerals for fetuses, which is now just passed in Texas. Under Pence, Purvi Patel and other women have been jailed for essentially miscarriages. So we have that second enforcement of the Trumpocalypse, that is Mike Pence. And we also have the right of conscience of the Christian right to deny women birth control in pharmacies and insurance plans. So the U.S. is in danger of becoming, like many countries in the world, one where abortion is not obtainable, and this results in 60,000 to 70,000 women a year dying of illegal botched abortions. We are about to join those countries if we do not stop it. Lastly, we have a third horseman of the Trump apocalypse. That's Paul Ryan and his henchman Tom Price, who is the new HHS, Health and Human Services chief. And that third face is austerity. As a result of male supremacist societies, women make less money than men and more impoverished and more dependent on public entitlements such as Social Security, food stamps, welfare, Medicare, and Medicaid. These are all programs that Paul Ryan's Congress and Tom Price's HHS want to shrink, want to privatize, want to abolish. So the overall vision for what is to happen for women if this unbelievably anti-women misogynist administration takes shape and goes forward is a great leap backward into subservience, aka barefoot pregnant in the kitchen. And the modus operandi is if you can't frighten them by threats of physical violence, you can force them to divert their energies into raising unwanted children, like Pence, or you can starve them into submission, like Ryan and Price want to do. So, are we going to accept this?
No.
I, for one, am not. Thousands, millions of women and our allies are not. There is already a lot of organizing going on. There is a march in Washington on the 21st. There is a women's strike by National Women's Liberation. There are all kinds of organizing taking place. And I want to commend this incredible effort, which all of us should be part of. We have got to stop them in their tracks as soon as we possibly can.